It's Christmas all over again. Greetings, trash fans. The February birthday saga continues with one of my favorite tenors of all time, Jussi Björling. Y'all, I have such a crush on this man's voice. It's just such a fresh, light voice. One might say, lemony fresh. Look at this teeny cake. You guys, it's so good. That's the best lemon cake I've ever had in my life. Seriously, though, we gotta get down to business here. First up, we have Jussi Björling singing a Swedish song here, Till Havs. I hope y'all like it. Och smeker ljuvlig sjömans kind av alla vindar rest. Till havs, till havs, till stav, järva jag. Anytime he gets anywhere near a high note, I just, like, my heart goes a-flutter. Till havs, till stav. Such passionate singing, but he's not blowing his voice out, which is, of course, very important.
Oh, endlessly der livet fritt, et livet tvang. Der havet sjunger grønt og fritt.
Does anybody know who that woman is in the background? Is she just a spectator? Someone let me know if you know.
Sin höga fritt.
Notice that he's hopping up to the high notes instead of sliding up to them. Very smart choice for this song.
Sväll härligt sköna segelsväll i vindens dust. Flyg fram med fröjd mot vågens fjäll i stundens högsta lust.
Classic tenor arms. Just love it. Oh my god, I dropped a piece of my cake. This is the worst thing ever. Next up, I know it's not Christmas anymore, but his recording of Oh Holy Night positively weakens me, so we're gonna listen to it. Smooth, so legato, huge contrast from what we just heard. This does things to my heart. Appreciated year round, right? And if you know me, y'all know I don't even like Christmas music, so this is kind of a big deal. Just pounces right on that note. Yes!
Oh,
those piano high notes kill me. So much that he sings with such heart, such passion, such fullness, but he does not allow his voice to become weighed down like a lot of tenors do. And I know you probably know what I'm talking about when they just get, they almost start to heave the sound out. I don't feel like UC Björling does that. I feel like he has a great balance between fullness and lightness. Okay, now we gotta hear the ending. It's Christmas all over again. Okay. And finally, we're going to finish it out with Nessun Dorma because he's a tenor, and of course we are. Nice diction. That he's kind of stretching it out, but it's not, I don't know if I want to use the word masturbatory, but you know what I'm saying? I need to take a second here. This next part's gonna destroy me. Dead. Okay, since the next part's just a repeated chunk, why don't I just finish my own self off and fast forward to the end? Great use of the Italian cry, great use of the ebb and flow that Puccini allows you to have, but I don't feel like it's overwrought. Just a quick and dirty look at UC Björling. I can't say enough good things about him. I just think his voice is just so perfectly balanced and his artistry is perfectly balanced. I don't think he does too much. I think he does just enough. And he's one of my faves. Happy heavenly birthday, UC Björling. So tell me what your UC Björling faves are, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe before you go.